please subscribe math.com for any query, comment or email.
Our today's lecture is on how you can find the discriminant from the quadratic equation and the nature of roots, as we have already discussed in our previous lecture that what is discriminant and how you can find that, or you can say that the nature of what is the nature of the roots. So we'll start with the example that you will be given with the quadratic equation and you'll ask what is the discriminant. So the equation is 6x square minus 8x plus 3 equals to 0. Now you have to find its discriminant. For that, first of all, what you need is the value of a, b and c. Okay, so first of all we'll write the coefficient of x square, that is a, is equals to 6, as it is clear from the quadratic, given quadratic equation. Then coefficient of x, that is equals to b, is minus 8, and the value of constant is, that is equal to c, is 3. Now we will put these values in the discriminant formula for in order to find the same. So discriminant is given by the formula, that is equals to b square minus 4ac. It is basically the values under the square root in the quadratic formula. So we'll put the values as b square is what? Minus 8 whole square minus 4 into what is a? It's 6, and what is c? It's 3. So we'll get 64 minus 72 and we get minus 8. Now the value of discriminant is minus 8. Okay, so this means that the value of discriminant is less than 0. So what will be the nature of the root in that case when the value of discriminant is less than 0? In that case, we will be having an imaginary, we will be having the roots that will be imaginary and complex conjugate. Okay, so we will get the imaginary roots by using the disk with the value that is less than 0. So the nature of roots will be, as we can easily determine by using the disk without solving the entire quadratic equation using quadratic formula. So disk will tell us what is the nature of the root. So as disk is less than 0, so the roots will be complex. The roots are complex or imaginary. So the roots are imaginary. Okay? You can say that complex conjugate. Okay, so this is how you can find the discriminant and accordingly the nature of the roots. Let's have one more example. Example number 2 is, you have to find the discriminant of 4x square minus 7x minus 2 equals to 0. So in this equation, coefficient of x square, that is a, is equals to 4, coefficient of x, that is b, is equals to minus 7, and the constant c is equals to minus 2. So we'll put these values into the equation. So we will put these values of a, b and c in the discriminant formula, that is b square minus 4ac. Value of b is minus 7 whole square minus 4, and a is 4 and c is minus 2. We'll solve it out. It will be 49 plus 32 equals to 81. So the value of discriminant that we have got is greater than 0, and it is also a perfect square, as it is a perfect square of 9. So we can say that the nature of root will be, this is the case 1, when we have the value of this greater than 0 and it is also a perfect square, then we will get two roots that are distinct and real number. Two roots that are distinct, that is unequal, and real number. So this is how we can find the discriminant, and accordingly we can check whether the roots that we will get are what is basically the nature of the roots that we have got after solving the discriminant. Okay. So one more example is, this is the last example. Actually, I want to cover the maximum cases as we can of finding the nature of the roots. So one more example is 2x square plus 3x minus 1 equals to 0. So in this equation, value of a is 2, b is 3, and c is equals to minus 1. So accordingly, we can find the discriminant as, we'll write the discriminant in short as this, b square minus 4ac. That is 3 square minus 4 into 2 minus 1 will be 9 plus 8, I'll get 17. So the discriminant came out here is 17. So we can say that the discriminant is greater than 0 and not a perfect square. In that case, what is the nature of the root? As we have discussed in our previous lecture, the nature of the roots in case when the disk is greater than 0 and not a perfect square will be, what will be the nature? The nature will be two roots that are irrational and unequal. So this is how we can find first the value of the discriminant, and accordingly we can say whether the roots that we have that we will be having by using the quadratic formula in order to solve the quadratic equations are either is having a real number of solution or the imaginary, or the roots with the, that are irrational or unequal. Okay, so that's all about how you can find the discriminant and then the correspondingly the nature of this. Thank you.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video, please don't forget to subscribe our channel math.com for more updates. Thank you.